The house business started by considering the Finance Institutions Amendment Bill 2023, which was passed amid disagreements from some legislators who wanted the Sharia Advisory Council to be maintained in the central bank to advise on regulation of Islamic banking. But the law was passed without the council that was provided in the 2018 amendment after government found it unnecessary. Bank of Uganda also told Parliament that they had failed to find Ugandan Sharia scholars with requirements to sit on the board.
I mean, Bank of Uganda, if you say it has not achieved it, it's because you lack the depth of strategic niche in Islam. I don't think the governor is a Muslim. I don't think you people are Muslims. So you don't know the human resource pool.
The Bank of Uganda should never determine the business model of any commercial institution. It should never sit and tell you what kind of product you should send to your customers. It should sit outside to determine whether that product is safe for the customers.
Members, I put a question that the Financial Institutions Amendment Bill 2023 be read the third time and do pass. Those in favor say on the contrary, nay. The ayes have it.
A bill for an act titled the Financial Institutions Amendment Act
2023. Passed and title settled.
Other bills to activate Islamic banking include the Excise Duty Amendment Bill 2023, which MPs passed to place a 15% excise duty on ledger, ATM, and withdrawal fees to bring Islamic banking products under the same tax regime as other banking products.
Forex bureaus are one of the low-hanging fruits for which so many of our local people pay. But when it comes to participating in the transfers, the cost will be 200 million, both local and foreign. Now, we have to be very careful as we make this law that we don't outcompete, that the foreign people don't completely wipe away our local people.
200 million, in our opinion, as a committee, we think it is not so big, given the amounts that they use.
The House has also reconsidered the National Sports Bill 2022, incorporating several amendments, including the introduction of archery and deletion of kickboxing. The National Sports Bill, initially tabled for first reading in November 2022, was passed by the House in March 2023. However, the bill was returned by the President with key amendments.
The committee has examined the proposal by His Excellency the President and observed that the National Sports Bill as returned by the President under Schedule 2 does not include kickboxing. Recommendation: the committee recommends that archery sports discipline be added as proposed by His Excellency the President since it is recognized by the National Council of Sports.
Most of these disciplines we are talking about are disciplines which are played under the Olympics to begin with for purpose of archery. Archery, most of you, there's almost a bow and arrow which is sharp and it is normally played in Olympic games.
Shown that the National Sports Bill 2023 has returned by His Excellency the President. Be read the third time and do pass. Those in favor say on the contrary, nay. The ayes have it.
However, still this week, the President returned two tax bills for reconsideration. The Income Tax Amendment Bill No. 1, 2023, and the Tax Procedure Code Amendment Bill 2023, which were passed in May. The President seeks to extend a tax waiver for Bujagali Hydropower Project for another 1 year and also wants Parliament to slap 5% tax on digital companies operating in Uganda like Twitter, Amazon, Facebook, TikTok, among others.
The clause related to non-residents and non-residents in Uganda, since it does not relate to residents in Uganda, as was mistakenly stated in the minority report, it should be reinstated.
This week, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, directed the Minister of Internal Affairs to investigate the recent killings in Bukoto County, Masaka District, where 5 family members were murdered last week. She called for heightening of security presence and other measures to prevent likely killings.
there is a need for a decisive and deterrent action on relevant authorities. So as we restore safety and confidence in our population in Masaka.
When this happened, we contacted the DPs of Masaka, but he had to contact the people in Masaka city to come for our rescue.
The division where I come from, Chimanya Kabonera, we have zero patrol vehicle, zero motorcycle that is moving. And it is a whole division. Right, Honorable, I want to request that in addition, when the Minister of Security is appraising this house on the issues of security in Masaka, he appraises us also on the facilitation of the police officers in that area so that they can respond to the security issues in that area.
This week, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, directed the Minister of Internal Affairs to investigate the recent killings in Bokoto County, Masaka District, where 5 family members were murdered last week. She called for tightening of security presence and other measures to prevent likely killings. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.